folks in the environmental movement know or should know that communities of color are most often the people that are most vulnerable to the impacts of climate change. We saw it in Sandy, we saw it in Katrina, and what we try to do at our job is figure out how can these communities be more resilient to the impacts of climate change while addressing climate change, the root causes of climate change as well. So what we do is we really try to support local solutions because these type of communities are innovating. They're innovating solutions to climate change, like solar panels, co-ops that are 100% sustainable and create jobs. We need to really support those type of community scale projects because oftentimes when we see big energy projects, they usually don't reach communities of color. You know, like there's a saying like, oh, you can just put a solar panel on your roof. But you can't do that unless you own your home, and it costs a lot of money, right? So, and especially since communities of color are going to be the most, the demographics are changing, right? We're going to be a majority people of color nation very soon. So we really need to start thinking about how can we support local solutions in those communities as well. We don't focus on fracking specifically, but I think that what we're seeing in this fracking debate is that there's very little transparency and accountability in this process. We're seeing fracking go through without the will of the people, right? You know, so I think that we really need to focus on keeping our elected officials accountable so we can stop practices like that really are harmful to not just communities of color, but everybody.
Fire. fracking.